Hi everyone, welcome back to another Placeit tutorial. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing some tips and tricks when you are creating t-shirt designs on Placeit. I've been using Placeit for a few years, and there are definitely some things I wish I knew when I first started out, and those are the things I'm going to share with you today. So, without further ado, let's go ahead and get started. Alright, so let's go ahead and jump right into this tutorial. So I'm going to share all of the tips, tricks, and little shortcuts that I've learned from using Placeit for a few years now. So the most common way to create t-shirt designs here on Placeit is to hover over designs, go to apparel, and then go to t-shirt designs. Now this upper menu has changed a few times over the years, but that is the main subcategory that you are going to be looking for. Now for most people creating t-shirt designs on Placeit, this is all of the designs that they ever find. There's 478 pages of t-shirt templates here, which is plenty to choose from. However, not many people know that there's an entire other section of design templates that you can use for t-shirt designs. This is something that took me a long time to learn from trial and error, but it opened up an entire door of different t-shirt templates that I could use. So all you have to do is go to logos, hover over logos, and don't use any of these dropdowns, just click directly on logos. And then instead of entering anything here, just click the small little button, see all of our templates. And now this is an entire other section with over 300 pages of more templates. Now these templates are technically made for business logos. However, they make excellent t-shirt designs, especially if you are a print-on-demand seller. Designs like these ones over here, where they have an intricate graphic that is built into the text, are things that typically were very hard to make in the past, and even the standard t-shirt design templates on Placeit had a hard time doing. With this logo section, it's just a few clicks of a button, you change the graphic, you change the font, and it wraps that text into the graphic and integrates them together. So that is my first really big tip for you guys. Now the second big tip I've got for you is, for many of you, you've been asking me, how do you create text-based designs on Placeit? A lot of the design templates here on Placeit have a graphic and text. Well, what about for those of you who want to create text-only designs? Well, there's two ways to do this as well. Starting in this logo section that we've just discovered, if you click the drop-down arrow, you scroll all the way down to the bottom, there's typographic. What that means is these designs are made primarily with text. So all of these templates, you're going to have 28 pages of the logo templates here that are text-based. Further, if you go back over to designs, and then you go to apparel and t-shirt designs, you can do the same thing along the left side here. So scroll all the way down to the T section and go to typography. Same thing, worded slightly differently. Now you will see some overlap in templates here. However, this will give you another 17 pages of text-only designs. Now this brings us right into the next really good tip that I've learned. When you are in any section looking at designs, looking at logos, looking at anything here on Placeit, this one little filter on the top left side is very important. If you click this filter and you go to best selling, it automatically sorts the most downloaded templates right to the top. Now if you are using Placeit to create t-shirt designs for print on demand, and you're selling these t-shirt designs on different print-on-demand websites, then you may be thinking that since these are the best-selling designs and they're the most downloaded, that you're going to have the most competition with designs similar to these. However, from having a lot of experience in this area, there are so many different niches that people are in print-on-demand, so the realistic likelihood of someone using the same template in your same niche on the same print-on-demand website is very low. So rather than thinking that these are the most saturated templates, I would use this best-selling filter to find the best-looking templates the fastest. Now before I get into the next couple tips, I just want to make a quick note to say that down in the description is a 15% coupon that Placeit has offered me to put on this channel and share with you guys. If you are interested in signing up for Placeit, they have monthly and annual plans, and the 15% coupon will give you 15% off of any of those plans. So with that being said, now I've got a couple more tips for you that are inside of the actual editor where you're customizing the templates. So I'm going to use this one for example. I'm just going to click into it. And there's a few really important things that took me a while to learn and hopefully will save you a lot of time and frustration. First things first is a lot of these templates come with different graphics and elements. Not all of them are elements that you want to include in your design. So for example, if I wanted to use just the text here and I didn't want to use this graphic, all you have to do is come over to the right side, and you're either going to see graphic or icon, and you can simply hit no image. Now when you hit no image, it's just going to remove that image from the design, and if you want to add it back in or add something different, you can click to add it back in. Now a little drawback to this is sometimes when you click no image, it alters the layout of the template. This doesn't happen on all templates. As you saw here, it didn't happen on this template. So if it does happen to you, all you have to do is use the undo button. You just click it right here, or alternatively, you can use the back button on your internet's browser, which will undo something as well. But then a nice little tip that I learned is if you don't want this in the design and hitting the no image messes up the layout, all you have to do is click and drag this off of the canvas. If you want it back, just click reset layout. But anything that you pull off of the canvas and drop out here is not going to be included in the design when you download it. Keep in mind, you can do this with any element. It can be text, it can be graphics, it can be anything. And if you did something on accident, you want it back, just hit undo. Now, the next very important thing you need to know if you're creating t-shirt designs here on Placeit is that before you download any t-shirt design, you need to make sure that the background is transparent. This is very simple to do, and this is one of the big benefits of using Placeit, is that it's simply a click of a button. So all you have to do to get rid of this background here and make it transparent is go to background on the right side, hit the drop down, and hit the checkerboard down here, which is transparent. The reason that this is so important before you download the design is when you put this on a shirt and you print it, you don't want it printed with that rectangular or square background color. You only want the text or the design that you've created to be printed on that shirt. Another small tip to keep in mind is make sure that the color of the shirt that you plan to print this on matches with the font. For example, if you plan to offer this on a black t-shirt, you can preview what that will look like. Same thing with the white t-shirt. Now, the reason that this is good practice to do is if you plan to offer this on a color shirt that is too similar to the text, you'll know right away that that is not going to work on that shirt. For instance, if we offer this on a pink purple shirt, you can see that the text is extremely hard to read. So when that gets printed on the print on demand shirt, it is not going to come out looking good. So simply keep that in mind that you don't want white text on a white shirt or black text on a black shirt. Now I've got one more really good tip for you guys, and this will be specific to print-on-demand sellers, especially if you are using merch by Amazon. So once we see that we like this design, I'm going to go ahead and click download. We'll give this just 1 second to process here, and then we can download that directly to our computer. Now if you click here to download, it goes directly to your computer. When we open that up, we have that design right here with a transparent background. This is ready to go onto print-on-demand websites. However, if you are selling on merch by Amazon, they have specific size requirements. What that is 4,500 pixels by 5,400 pixels. Not all of these templates that you create on Placeit come in those size dimensions. So Placeit actually has a tool built in for that, so you don't have to go around resizing and reformatting these designs so that you can upload them to merch by Amazon. So in order to do this, all we do is go back to Placeit. We scroll all the way up to the top. We click on My Downloads, View All, and then find the design that you just created. Click the drop down arrow, go to Crop and Resize. It will automatically load the design that you just created, and scroll down just a bit and use the custom presets to be 4,500 by 5,400. Now you can simply click download once again. Click here to download, and this will download that exact same design except formatted properly for merch by Amazon. Now the good thing to know is if you do this for all of your designs, they will upload properly to merch by Amazon, but they will also be accepted to all the other sites like Teespring and Redbubble as well. This tip alone should save you a ton of time. All right guys, that's it for this tutorial. Hopefully that has been helpful. Don't forget about the 15% coupon down in the description. That will give you a nice little discount on any of the plans that you're signing up for with Placeit. All right, that's it for this one. I will see you all in the next tutorial.